This is TWiT.
Hello, everyone. Happy Friday. I'm Sarah Lane, and let's get right into today's tech feed, shall we? A new survey from the Pew Research Center, they love doing their surveys there, conducted back in September of 2014, and based on the 81% of American adults who use the internet, shows that Facebook's growth has slowed, but the level of user engagement on the network has actually increased, especially with the older set. Specifically, more than half of online adults 65 and older now use Facebook, which represents 31% of all seniors. Other interesting data from the survey, 52% of online adults now say they use two or more social media sites. That's a pretty big jump from just 42% back in 2013. And about half of younger adults, that's ages 18 to 29, say that they use Instagram. Now, of the total Instagram user base, that it's quite a great engagement, 49% are on the network every single day. In the world of Pinterest, somewhat unsurprisingly, women still rule that network. 42% of online women are on the site, compared with just 13% of online men. The Wall Street Journal is reporting that Twitter wants to make money when people read a tweet that may have originated on Twitter, even if the person is reading that tweet somewhere else on the internet. People familiar with the matter tell the Journal that the company will sell ads within streams of tweets on other publishers' apps and websites, and that the company already laid out its strategy to media buyers in a presentation at CES this week. So Google's been offering its Compare auto insurance shopping site in the UK for a couple of years now. The New York Times is now reporting that the same feature may come to the US soon, with sources claiming that Google recently formed a partnership with the insurance comparison shopping site comparenow.com. Ellen Carney, who's an analyst at Forrester Research, also says that the company is now licensed to sell insurance in more than half of the US. Now, because the insurance industry is very highly regulated, the way it'll work is that users go to a site, like Google in this case, enter some of their personal details, and then they get rates from various insurers. When they decide to buy the site, Google in this case, would collect a referral fee from the insurance company, but the site also has to be licensed to sell insurance on behalf of the companies that give them quotes. Heads up to Apple users, InfoWorld is passing along a report from German tech news site Heise today, hope I'm saying that right, that a glitch in OS X Yosemite can expose private details of Apple Mail users, stuff like IP addresses, to spammers or phishers or online tracking companies. So here's what's going on. Spotlight Search indexes emails received via Apple Mail. Or it can anyway. And when you're searching on a Mac, Spotlight shows previews of those emails and then automatically loads external images linked in HTML email. Spotlight loads those files even if a user has switched off the load remote content in messages option in the Mail app and loads those files when it shows previews of unopened emails that went straight to a junk folder. Now, if you're wondering, how do I avoid this issue? By unchecking the Mail and Messages box for Spotlight in your system preferences, that should do the trick at least for now.